causes brain damage in J.C. Bailey when Danny Havoc was injured, breaking his heel. Masada, he was actually tired for this matchup. Masada actually agreed to fill in. He has that much respect for Danny Havoc, the man he faced when he debuted here in the conference.
Yeah, Havoc actually asked Masada to be his partner. He wanted him on his side. He wanted him with a neck. That's right! Oh my God!
What is this? What is this? Masada with a shot right to the head of Vortex.
And here's Danny Havoc. He has no business being in that ring.
Get out of that ring. Get out of that ring.
The man's got a broken heel.
Oh!
But you think brain damage? You think brain damage cares? No, he doesn't care. Because here we go. Pulp Fiction is laying it to Danny Havoc.
Are you kidding me? Oh, here comes Younger. Younger Kingston. Younger Kingston have hit the ring.
We're the tag team champions.
You know, the sad thing is, I got respect for each and every one of you guys. But you want to come here and turn your back on these fans and put the backbone of our company, Danny Havoc, on the shelf? Well, that ain't gonna fly here. South Philly, you want to see a six-man home run derby? Ring the bell, come on!
If you like violence, then we have a treat for you. Six-man home run derby, derby deathmatch.
Festivus has come early for the ultraviolet wrestling fan. Here we go, the new tag team champions, Eddie Kingston, Drake Younger, and Scotty Vortex pick off Masada, Brain Damage, and J.C. Bailey with Billy Graham, Pulp Fiction.
And what could this mean? Is Masada simply aligned to that, or is Masada actually a member?
I'm thinking Billy Graham got his set too. Billy Graham can offer things that other people can't, and right now in the ring though, Scotty Vortex has got a bad attack and takes to the skull of J.C. Bailey.
Tag flying absolutely ever. Look at the tag to the shoulder of J.C. Bailey. He got him in the back of the head. He got him in the shoulder blade.
And look on the outside. Brain Damage taken to the former world champion, Drake Younger. And Billy Graham is just smiling in delight. But in the ring. Christ, man, it's so wild. Knocked him silly. In the head.
Oh, and we're being joined now by Danny Havoc.
I cannot believe this shit. This has been a problem of mine ever since I joined CZW. I guess my Midwestern background, my upbringing, but I'm too goddamn trusting. Masada and I don't have friends, but...
Subject, but Masada swings down like he's Pedro Serrano, and he just took it to Scotty Vortex.
Clearly, God hates the teeth and jaws of Scotty Vortex and myself. Masada, I hate this guy. Motherfucker turned on me. I thought we had this mutual respect. He told me mutual respect. They seemed heartfelt. They seemed earnest. And God damn it.
You know what? It might be a mutual respect he has for you, but it was a spiritual decision to join Billy Graham.
I absolutely cannot believe this shit. I hate to give him credit after what he's just done. Masada joining Brain Damage, dude, the hardest hitting man I've ever seen. I thought if there was anybody that I could bring in to replace. I'm sorry, my jaw is halfway broken.
Well, no one blames you. The man with the strongest punch in all wrestling, Brain Damage. To you, but if it's any consolation, Drake Younger and Eddie Kingston have their back thick and thin.
There are two people that I feel like I can honestly trust, and clearly there aren't as many as I thought. Drake Younger, Scotty Vortex are two of them. Eddie Kingston is coming out to get my back. I really appreciate this. I have every faith. It's hard hitting, it's brain damage. Masada is as dangerous as J.C. Bailey is. I have every faith. Oh.
Now, Leonard, you
want to
chime in here and call the action of the fans?
Oh, absolute brutality. What am I going to say? It's brutality. This is an absolute war.
You know, very emotional situation for Danny Havoc. It's great to have him up here. What?
Oh, I'm good.
Watch my eyes deconstruct.
And look at the tags.
A series of baseball bat type weapons.
It's the swing for the fences death match here. Swing for the fences. Home run derby death match.
Masada gives him confidence. Masada gives him take out brain damage, and then, God, I don't know what we're going to do.
Right now, Masada's taking it to Drake Younger. Absolutely drives those toxins. Oh, God, what a shot. That might have been a home run on Vortex's head for JC Bailey. Go for the cover now. Oh, so close.
All right, guys, get back in this. Sorry, I'm a very laid back person. I'm calm. I like to make jokes. I like to try and be amusing. I'm very worked up about this situation. My friends here, all three of whom have already wrestled a match tonight. Back out here, trying to get my back in one of the worst times of my life.
Butterfly suplex from Masada there.
Especially when two of these powerhouses, Masada and Brain Damage, and JC Bailey, which is a nut, are led by Billy Graham.
Billy Graham, I have absolutely... Oh, come on, Drake.
Oh! Carpet sweep to the midsection of Masada. And Younger raking the tacks across his back. Shot right to the forehead.
Get that turn.
Such ultraviolence in this contest. The war between the Naptown Dragons, yourself, and now Eddie Kingston and Pulp Fiction has come to this.
Worst time for a serious injury. I realized statistically I was probably long overdue. But right in the middle of this warfare with Pulp Fiction is absolutely the worst time to take me out of action. Fortunately, some friends of mine in the back are stepping up to aid me.
Now, Danny, how much time are you looking to miss here?
I honestly have no idea. It could be anywhere from 6 weeks to 3 months. I haven't gotten a decent prognosis yet. Hopefully, I'll be back by tournament of death to make some of these fuckers pay.
And imagine if realize the damage a Pulp Fiction could do.
I don't even want to think about it, honestly.
Especially with a man like Masada now.
A smile on your face.
That is absolutely wonderful. I'd like to see some more of that immediately.
Younger now trying to put up Masada. Masada puts in the brakes.
No. I hate to sit here and watch my good friends get hurt because I can't be in there.
You can't be in there because of your health. But the health of your friends is in serious danger dealing with Pulp Fiction.
And Billy Graham, I don't even know what his goddamn problem is. He's always been weird, but we used to be cool. And then something about the fact that I made amends with the Necro Butcher has turned him against me. He's going on a tirade, and I honestly don't even know where it's coming from. But it doesn't make a goddamn bit of difference now because the blood has been spilled, and I'm in this to the end.
And there is a lot of blood being spilled right now in that ring. Just about every man in there. Hunter, look at Bambi. Completely off.
Yeah, I think that was actually the barbed wire that so well. He hit him so hard, it didn't even stick to the bat. It just went flying. And that pissed off Brain Damage.
That's not a man you want to piss off.
No, and you've done it.
That's more than enough teeth for that man.
And look at Damage now. Look at him.
JC Bailey, one of the original hybrid deathmatch wrestlers. We're facing hell of odds here. Now they're bringing Bobby Carlos next. I don't know.
That's over my head.
Look at Bailey now.
Nice cover by JC Bailey. Pop back this time. Who would have thought?
I don't give any credit to JC Bailey. He's a friend of mine. JC Bailey thought off about how nobody visited him in prison. Nobody wrote him while he was locked up. That's bullshit. I wrote this man while he was locked up.
Younger's out.
A friend of mine, I wrote him when he was locked up. He got out. He tells me I didn't write him enough. I didn't visit him. A few letters, that's not nearly enough.
Wow.
10 hours of my God. That's not enough.
No, but you gotta be loving it.
Well, I'll be honest with you, as much as I wish I could get in there right now, I am glad that I didn't reach this particular part.
Oh,
boy, turn it around, Drake.
And right now, your friends are definitely in firm control.
politics is from the streets, bitch.
I don't know if you know. I'm aware. Eddie Kingston, well, I assume he's probably from the streets. I've heard him talk. He gives that impression off.
Drake Younger, longest reigning world heavyweight champion in CZW's history, if I'm correct.
You are correct. And he's also one of the nicest, men in the world until you mess with his friend.
Absolutely. A lot of people in this company over the years have proven that I have misplaced my faith and trust in them. Drake Younger has never betrayed me. And I feel confident that he never will. Scotty Vortex, Drake Younger, good friends of mine, coming to my aid when I needed it. Thank
Look
you.
At this. Look at this tower of
boom.
Oh! Absolutely
brutal. I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep quiet here. I want to let Mr. Havoc have his say here. He has so much invested in this matchup. But, I mean, you see a move like that, you got to call it.
You got to call the match, so that's your job. Can't force your foot.
But all of these men are laying it on the line. The hatred that is running through their brain veins and their blood that is also spilling out of them at the same time is definitely on demonstration here.
Absolutely. But what does it mean for, I hesitate to call them my team, but my friends out there, that they have all had to wrestle once tonight?
It's not a good sign, I'll tell you that. Toe to toe, Masada and Eddie Kingston talking trash.
Oh, and here we go.
This is a fight I want to see. Both of these men hard as fuck.
I'm not going to
out here. Me too. I can never do the wire tapings. I wouldn't be allowed.
Oh, look at these backhands. Oh!
Nice block, Kingston. Get on him. Get on him.
Oh! Oh. Right to the
ball.
That's why I got that man on my side. Fuck the side. I don't need him. Trick anyone.
And just so I can throw out a curse word for here. Holy fuck. Oh, God! In the back! The danger and the unhinged violence is coming through in this Queen for the Fences death match.
Keep your eyes on Damage. Damage going with the cover there.
You've been through a lot tonight, man. Keep it together.
You know, getting hit with brain damage is fish. Works worse than getting hit by a pitching machine. He's so rapid and forceful with it.
Absolutely one of the toughest men I've ever ever been in the ring with, and I've been in the ring with some incredibly tough men. But he also has this...
Oh, he's going for the cover here!
He also has this severe mental problem. He seems to be under the sway of Billy Graham. I can't imagine. I've spoken to Billy Graham. He's obnoxious and irritating. I do not understand how he gets this man into his cult, for lack of a better word, but he does seem to have some sort of strong influence over them.
He finds something they need in their life, and he picks at it and takes advantage of it. He gives it to them. That's all they need, and he gets them under his control.
I was of the impression that he just rubbed paint on their chests, and then they did his taxes.
And maybe I can take
Oh! Spider German suplex into the chair!
The inches of multiple chairs tonight. That boy Drake.
Scotty Vortex is perhaps an unassuming looking man in CZW, but he's one of the toughest I will ever meet.
Hard as fuck. From the streets. That man right there.
Oh! Bailey with the cover now.
Come on, kick out.
Oh!
And for the second time, JC Bailey has been Drake Younger in 2010.
Incredible matchup here at Swinging for the Fences, my God. I mean, Masada seeming to have joined Cole Fischer, at the very least aligned with him. I mean, what can this mean for the combat section?
Hey, Havoc, I got a phone call. I heard that freaking nature, brain damage, took you out. Sounds like you guys are down one man. Well, guess what, brain damage? They're not down one man anymore. It's going to be me and you, Bray Damage. May 8th at the arena. And I'm not one of these little punks that you've been beating up on. This face can take a punch. And I guarantee you, this fist can give one.
The sisters, the fathers.